we want to extend UT game, basically, so I've lost context for the moment. Right, I've just where that other video ended, I've pasted in the rest of the code from the custom game, and I've referenced all my bits for the GTA game here. So the player controller, obviously I'm going to call it GTA 11 player controller. So that first variable where it says custom player controller, I've changed it there. Then there, which said custom player controller again. Then here, I've also changed the class, because it's the game, the folder is there, GTA 11, and then the class is GTA player controller. I haven't changed it there yet. Sorry, the acronym. Oh, I haven't got it in again. So copy, paste, save. Still got the custom pawn commented out, but now the player controller class is basically that line there without the semicolon. So after the equals, in fact you could copy that whole line there before the semicolon, go copy and then paste that there, cover the whole line. That would have the custom player controller be in reference, go paste, see, so it's exactly the same again, then go save. So the next thing is the player controller, so download, copy the player controller, custom player controller off of my website, and then whatever your game, your player controller is going to be called. I've called this for simplicity GTA 11 player controller. So we open that up. I then pasted in all the code into this, and here I just referenced, I named it GTA 11 player controller. Extends UT player controller. Well, that part of the code is already there. And then down here, I've commented out all the... I don't need to comment out because I've got a character already to reference here. Delete that. And I don't have to delete the anon tree. Whoops. I've deleted the D there. And now I can delete that out. See, this is referencing all your assets in the content browser that you would have already created for your custom character. Well, the first one is there, the mesh. Second one is your anim tree. Third is your anim set. Now, if you've used the Epic based skeleton, using following my tutorials, rigging your character with Epic based skeleton, you can use, let's just start the UDK out. We're not going to rebuild scriptures yet because I want to show you what you can use there. The anim tree, so if your character has the Epic skeleton, you just go into characters, no, not that one, 90 nodes, that's the one. So go copy full name to clipboard of that AT underscore CH underscore human anim tree back into your code, and then reference it here. After the equals, just paste the whole line in. Go paste, so you can use that anim tree. Edit, undo. And then your anim set, if you look further down in this folder, use not the offset one, the k underscore anim human underscore base male. Copy full name to clipboard, go back into your code and paste that into your anim set. So go after the equals, the whole line, just go paste. So it's referencing that anim set now. And then you can even use the physics asset actually for Iron Guard. What you'd have to do though, before you do this, is find Iron Guard's physics asset. So find Iron Guard characters, Iron Guard, mesh, open it up, go into the properties box here and find its physics asset. It doesn't seem to have one. I could have sworn it did. Oh no, so sorry, you're going to have to create your own physics asset. Let's show Bounds for a minute if we can. See if he has got one. Now anyway, I'm not going to start messing around with this. So you've got to create the physics asset, but watch Jeremy Ernst's video on that on the UDN forums under learning. Oh, I've forgotten the bloody name of it now. Lex videos, UDK video tutorials, no, it's not that physics one. You want training, and then training physics assets. Find, download all these videos for free. This is the one. He is the technical animator for Epic Games, and he shows you how to create a simple physics asset for your character. So then you can reference that in the code. If you haven't got the physics asset though, just comment it out. All it means is when you get your everything all up and running, when you die, your character won't fall over and look like he's dying. He'll just stand there in his reference pose. It's not the end of the world. You can always work on that at a later date. The most important thing is getting your character running in game. So right, we've copied all that in into our player controller class, making sure we're referencing, cross-referencing each thing here. So the in the default properties of the player controller, making sure we've got this line of code right. The GTA 11 player controller as default. Now that we could have copied from here. Go copy. And then we could have just pasted that in there. Oops, but we didn't need that part at the beginning of it. Go delete, and then just go save again, and then it's just basically not cross, making sure you've removed all the references to custom player controller, unless, I mean, the simple way around it would be to avoid any mistakes, before you've altered any code, your own class system could be called custom. So your class folder, obviously you've got to reference that, and that is in the default properties. Let's just drop this down for the moment. Oh, it's not referenced here at all in the player controller. No. But it is in the game. And that is somewhere. Custom. Oh, it's not, no. Yes, it is there. It would have been in there. Let's just open that up to show you what I mean. Dave Saxon, classes, custom game. Yeah, see where it says Dave Saxon, that's the name of my folder. All you've got to do is reference your own one there, and then there again. Up there. So, say yours was John Smith, and you put that there, John Smith. The name of your folder, that is. This folder here, which is the where all your classes will live, basically. And inside that, we've got our classes. So, yeah, you could actually call your game type custom game for simplicity. Then you wouldn't have to change all these references to the different player, to the player controller and the pawn, because it would already be all written in there. But your folder, you'd have to change the references to that. So, now what have we got so far? I'll shut down the editor. So that's the player controller, now can go into the classes folders. Development, SRC, GTA 11. Oops, no, in there, and then go paste. So the last thing now is the custom pawn. This has got very few references, but what this is referencing is your skeletal mesh again. There. If you haven't got the physics asset, all you do is you go comment this out for the moment. With two forward slashes. But if you have, then reference it here after the equals. And then your anim tree, the same anim tree, we just put in the player controller, which would be after the equals here, so you copy the full name to clipboard again. Or you can go into your player controller class, I think we put it in. And let's find it again quickly, go UDK, development, SRC, GTA 11 classes, player controller. Yeah, it was here. So you just copy it from here. Go copy. And then back into your pawn. And then go paste. Yeah, same one. Go save. But I'm going to undo that. Oh no, it's the same one. Anyway, I thought I had a different one being referenced. Yeah, character 2 is epic me. Ignore that last comment I just made. So, I commented this out because I can't remember why. But obviously I haven't needed it, so... Yeah, so there's only three references in your custom pawn. I think. Let's just double check, making sure there's no reference to the folder. Not, doesn't seem to be. So that's it for the custom pawn. Now we can shut that, shut context. And now we can place the pawn in here as well. And then the next step is boot up the editor. Should get zero errors and zero warnings. If you do get any errors or any warnings, it will have... I mean, the error itself sometimes isn't obvious by what they say, what it will say in red writing here, but it will give you the line it is in what class. So say the error was in the GTA 11 game. It would say GTA 11 class, GTA 11 game, error, blah blah blah, and then it would have the line it was on it's on. So you'd go back into context. Let's open up the UDK, the GTA 11 game again. Development, SRC, GTA 11 game, classes. Now, say we had, let's make a mistake for it to find. We will put a 2 forward slashes there. And now this should come up with an error. Save it. Shut the editor. Or not the editor. Yes. There you go. So we've got an error. Now the error is on line 23. And it's in the SRC GTA 11 classes GTA 11 game.uc on line 23. So now we go view, go to line, find line 23, and then go OK. See, notice, oh, it's got it, it's got the line wrong slightly by one. But all we do is then go delete out that, go save again. Now it will get you either on the line, correct line, or the line above it, or the line below it. And you can often see what you've done wrong there. Like, say, for example, I'd accidentally put a semicolon in there now. If I did, this writing would turn white now. I'll show you. No, I've done the wrong one. It's because I'm trying to do this in darkness, actually. Where's my semicolons? Oh, it didn't turn white anyway. Edit. Undo. We go save, boot it up. Yes. And our error will be gone now. There you are. And see, notice our little code, our file is here. Now we should, our script file should be slightly larger as well. UDK game, scripts, GTA 11, yeah, 19 kilobytes. It started out at 2 or 4, I think it was, and it's growing as we successively add more classes to our folders, to our folder, I should say, our source folder. And it is as simple as that, really. You just keep building on that, and then you'll get to the stage eventually. I've just been creating this class file now for about a year, and I'm in my own specific game type. There's all my classes. A lot of them are weapons. So what we'll do in the next tutorial is we'll go over covering the weapon classes. Bit more complex than creating a class for a character or a class for a pawn or a player controller. Now, with those classes that we've just made, anyway, I'll quickly show you what you can now do with them. By referencing your mesh in the pawn and the player controller, we can now add in, and it's also a third person setup, which you can comment out if you want to do it in first person. Just comment out all the functions. Perhaps I'll show that in the next tutorial as well, or in another tutorial, just to show you if you are interested in creating a custom first person game and not third. Let's open the pub bomb booby trap map. Hey, where's the where's my bloody builder brush gone? Now G normally unhides that. Oh, that's weird. Just quickly save that. Don't know why that was missing there. Might be something. Ah. Yeah, I wasn't in game mode.